What about a component that's more complex and requires some programming and a lot more peripherals, like, for example, an FPGA? Well, let's take a look at an example here on Octopart. So here we have a Xilinx FPGA part number that I'm searching for, and you can see here that there is a dev board available. And I really like using dev boards as a way to identify some of the real basic peripherals that you're going to need just to work with this particular FPGA part number. So let's go ahead and open up this page on the Octopart website, and then you can see here we have access to the datasheet. Now, we can already see a couple of things that we're going to need here immediately. One of those things is we're going to need some RAM for our application, and then we're going to need an EEPROM or serial flash. Here, if I go over to the datasheet and I scroll down, you can actually identify some peripherals that you might need from this datasheet. And as you scroll down, there is a section on power supplies. These power supplies are showing you all of the different power levels that you're going to need to work with this particular FPGA.